All right, we're back. I'm Jeff.
I'm Jeff.
And what we're going to do today, we're going to cover both the Monday night games. But first, we're going to cover the early game, the 7 o'clock game between the Baltimore Ravens and the New York Jets. That's going to be the first game ever for the Jets in the new stadium. Big game. It's going to be a lot of hard-hitting. I want to say it's going to be a really high-scoring game, although it's possible with both teams' offenses. They could score some points, but I think with both teams' defense, I think they're going to keep the game 20 points or less on both sides. But I think the Jets, with the emotions riding high in the new stadium, I think the Jets are going to pull out. I think it's going to be closer. What do you think, though?
Yeah, it's going to be a close game to the defenses, but they do have good offenses, though. But I do think the defenses are better than the opposing team's offenses. Darrell Revis,
he's back.
Good. He'll be able to shut down whoever he's covering.
Yeah.
So...
I don't know if he's going to have Mason or Bolden, because I think TJ, who's your mom, is, might be in the slot, so
yeah.
I'm not sure, but whoever Revis is covering,
shut him down.
He's going to have to shut him down, because the rest of the defense is going to have to worry about with Rice or Flacco throwing a heap, one of those other two wideouts that Revis isn't covering. That's a big concern for the Jets. They're going to need to shut down Rice with the running game, and they're going to have to get some pressure on Flacco, can't let him stand there all day. Sooner or later, he'll pick somebody out.
Probably looking for heap most of the game.
Yeah, well, it's a good, it's like a security blanket right there. If he can get Rice or whatever, he usually finds his way open, and he can hit him, and he could certainly have a big game. Now, on the other flip side, you got Sanchez, second year, coming off of a very successful first year. Sometimes quarterbacks get that sophomore slump. We'll have to wait and see. They don't have Santonio Holmes. He's out for a few games. They got him. If they get the Braylon Edwards that can catch any pass thrown to him with his eyes closed, he can certainly have a humongous game, because Ravens don't have Ed Reed. Sometimes Edwards comes a little human-like, and you throw a ball right to him, and he can drive it.
We'll have to wait and see. Passes.
Yes. Now, you got the Jets' great offensive line, Ravens' great defensive line. Sean Green running the ball, the experience and the leadership of LT coming in, I'm sure, from time to time will help him out.
Mm-hmm.
As I said, there'll be a lot of hard hitting. Wouldn't be surprised if you see a couple scuffles out there on the field. Don't be surprised if you see some guys going face mask to face mask, joining each other, especially Mr. Ray Lewis out there. But I think in the end, when it was all done, I think the Jets come out with maybe like a 3-point victory on this one. I think this is very key for them. I got the Ravens losing this one and still winning the division. So I think if the Jets lose this one, because they got Baltimore and New England first two games, it's two big games for the Jets. Jets have to start off with a victory right here.
Yeah, I also have the Jets winning. We need to start out with a tough division with the Patriots.
Oh, yeah.
You need to win the first two games, but they got to start with the first one.
Yeah,
and if they can beat Baltimore, then they'll be in good shape.
Oh, yeah.
Conference. Especially at home.
Big home game, very big confidence booster, and hopefully it'll give them the confidence, because they only have 6 days off. Because New England's playing on Sunday, New England's going to have 7 days off. The Jets only have 6 days off to prepare for New England next Sunday. That's all the time we got for it right now, but when we come back, we're going to preview the second Monday night game, San Diego at Kansas City. But until then, I'm Jeff,
okay.
And we're going to see you on the gridiron.